My childhood was a very simple childhood because I was an absolute dreamer. I was not an achiever in any way, shape or form. I wasn't making it to anybody else's level. I was just a straggler. And when I had to move from my preschool to big school, I went to Loreto Convent and my mother went to the nuns and begged them and said, "Meri badi beti hai, please sister take my younger one." They said, "But she doesn't know anything." And my mother cried with tears and said, "But please take her, I can't separate my two girls." So if anything, my childhood was quite a non-starter. But the things that were very prime in my childhood was my grandmother. She was a very prominent figure for me. I adored her. She was deeply religious and very spiritual. So from childhood, I was inclined to be quite, involved with Jap and just be lost to things around. They didn't really matter to me. I used to say the Hanuman Chalisa, and my nani had said, "Say it early in the morning." I used to wake up at the crack of dawn and recite the Hanuman Chalisa. You know, the thing is, childhood is not adulthood. You don't have to have a job, you don't have to excel, and you don't have to please people. Childhood is about your journey. It's about your coming into the world, and the most important thing in childhood is observation and experience. So what parents don't realize is that when you are trying to get your child to do things, you know, even for something as serious as board exams, tum fail ho jaoge, tum padhte nahi ho, focus, don't do your extracurricular. I think these are really not the correct nurturing things for children. Board exams are baad ki baat, but early childhood is all about observation, and what you learn from 0 to 6 is more than what you'll ever learn in your whole life. So your whole ability to make relationships and to appreciate your ecosystem is dependent on those experiences. Love, no judgment, accepting the child for what they want to do and when they want to do it. You know how sometimes a parent may come and say that my child is not speaking, or my child is not reading, or whatever the thing is. I always say, why are you worried about this, reading and writing? Most people read and write, no? But how many climb Mount Everest? So why don't you become more ambitious for your child? Give them an environment which makes them unique, which makes them happy. So when you love what you do, you're not working. So it's great fun. So not only do you have joy, but you also have excellence as a result of being able to do what you like to do. Everybody has their potential. The worst thing anybody around in a family or in an educational ecosystem can do is to say, "You can't." It's always nice to say, "Try that. Maybe you'd like to try that instead." But to say, "You can't," is a very debilitating thing. My grade one teacher, Mrs. Chandra, she may not have been hugely accomplished or, you know, something spectacular, but she was an oasis of love. And we just adored her. And my luck could not have been more heightened, but when she got promoted with us from grade one to grade two. So I remember her so clearly as being a great person of significance in my life. My dance Guruji, Guru Srinath Raut, he was the gentlest soul. And when I started dancing at age 8 or 9, I don't think I would have ever taken dance seriously but for him. And it was because he never forced me. So I used to say, "Guruji, aaj man nahi hai." And he would just humor me. If it was holy, I would, you know, put some pani on, from the chhat on him as he was coming. But he just humored me. And he would show me his book of sketches. He would sketch out the dance moves, not to show me what to do, but just a sharing. And everyone used to wear their uniforms when they were in dance class because they had group classes. I had solo classes at home. So I skirt pehen ke aa jaati thi. He never scolded me or anything. And because he gave me so much love, that's when I decided to take dance seriously. So he was hugely instrumental in my dance journey becoming my life journey. I think for schools, it's really important to keep opening windows, because every child will see through the window differently. Their perspective will be different. But if you shut that window, they never have exposure to that particular thing. So it's not about identifying excellence for the child, what the child excels in or has an interest in, but it's about creating an interest for the child in different things. So I think today the age for children is very specialized. So the thing for a school or a parent to do is to provide all the opportunities, and then, you know what, they are going to be able to decide what they want. Enable them to make those decisions rather than, you know, structured to such a degree that they are bound by shackles.